Welcome to MS Excel tutorial, where we will show you how you can convert your Excel into a real-time data processing and visualization application. Today, we will create an add-in, which will calculate and refresh data on given intervals. Then we will connect our MS Excel file to a SQL Server database and retrieve data in real time. So let's start our tutorial. First of all, we need to customize the ribbon and turn on the Developer tab. Then we will go to the Developer tab and add an Excel add-in to update Excel in real time. First, we will place the add-in inside the add-in folder. This is the add-in that we will place inside the add-in folder. This is the add-in folder where we place all the Excel add-in files. Now, we will add this add-in to our Excel file. Click on the Browse button and select the add-in file. Make sure it is checked and click OK to add the add-in. Now right-click anywhere on the sheet and you will see some new menu items. These are created by the add-in. These are used to calculate and refresh file after a specific interval, which can also be set here. Let's test the add-in using a random function in our Excel file. Random function generates a random value, but it does not get updated automatically. However, when we will enable calculation, it will start updating after the given interval. The default interval is set to 2 seconds. And as you can see, the random values are generating after 2 seconds. We can also change the interval from the same menu. Let's change it to 1 second. Now, the random values are updating per second. We can stop this add-in by clicking on the Stop All button. After which Excel will stop updating calculations. Let's enter some random XY values. We will use the random formula to generate random numbers. Now we will select the range and insert an XY scatter chart. Then we will turn on the real-time calculation. This way we can create various simulations and graphically display them in our Excel file. While the calculation is enabled, we can normally use MS Excel and work on anything, such as adding a trend line to our chart. The add-in does not disrupt our ability to work in the same file. Let's turn off the add-in for now and delete data from our sheet. Now we will test real-time data extraction from SQL using Excel. Let's connect to our SQL Server. In our SQL Server, we will create a new database named SQL Stats. The database will be listed inside the Databases folder. Now we need to create a table inside this database. We will use this query to create a database table to store memory usage statistics. We will use this query to enter data into the table we just created. Let's execute the query and view the data. Data has been entered into the table. We can use the select command to view the data. Here is our data. Now we can remove the unnecessary queries. We will modify this query to enter data per second to memory stats table. We will place this code inside a while loop, which will iterate per second and execute this query. We will delete old data before executing this query. Let's execute the query and see what it does. The data has been entered, which we can view using the select command. Now, we will go to the MS Excel and connect to the SQL Server. We can get the server name from SQL Server Management Studio. We can also take the table name from there. Press OK to connect to the SQL Server. In the Navigator window, select the table and click on the Load button. This will display the SQL table data into an Excel table. Let's select the available memory columns and insert a line chart. Now we will enable refresh from our add-in menu. We will also set the interval to 1 second. This will refresh the connection with SQL Server every 1 second, and both table and chart will be updated. As the data is updated in the SQL Server table, it is imported into the Excel table, and the chart displays the same immediately. Finally, let's take a quick look on how to create an add-in. First, we open a blank Excel file. Then we save the file as an Excel add-in in the MS Excel add-in folder. Enter a name for your add-in and click on the Save button. Now, close this file and go to the add-in folder and open the add-in file. This file has no sheets in it. Now, go to the Developer tab and in Visual Basic, expand the project and insert a module. In this module, you can add VBA code to perform functions you want your add-in to perform. Just like we wrote this code, which creates menus in the context menu and performs real-time calculation and refresh. Now we can go to any MS Excel file and add this add-in to our file. We can also browse and add this add-in. This is how Excel add-ins are created. And with this, we end our tutorial. Link to the VBA and SQL codes is placed in the comments below.